We're here with Simon Deng at the Freedom Walk, where he'll be walking to Washington. We have the UN behind him, that collective negation of humanity, and Simon Deng, hero, freedom fighter. Can you tell us what you hope to achieve here today, please?
What we're trying to achieve, even that we are not going to achieve anything with the United Do Nothing Nations, but we are telling the UN, which is behind me today, as a world body, as a world community, as a place where supposed to be uphold the principles of the declarations, which is the Human Rights Declaration, which is supposed to be the law of the UN, in which that the issue of slavery, it is there, the issue of genocide, it is there, the issue of people are born as equal, it is there. But when it comes to the case of the Sudan, the United Nations always have a different way by coming to have this word on it. We are trying to tell them, because the issue of Sudan is going to be discussed here at United Nations on 24th, I think next week. We're telling them that, yes, they have to look in the eyes of the Southern Sudanese who are going to be there, because there are two delegations is going to be there. The Northern delegation has represented the nation of Northern Sudan, and the Southern Sudanese represented the nation to be born in January 9, 2011. Let's look in the eyes of those individuals being sent by the millions of Southern Sudanese. Yes, what they're being saying, it will not be sound loudly to the UN, but it is very clear even that will be sent by the small, tiny Southern Sudanese leader that they have big, gigantic, tall guys behind them in Southern Sudan. The will of Southern Sudan should not be denied. On self-determination, which is coming up in January 9, less almost under 100 days from today, the United Nations have to work to make way of transitions for the nation to be born. A nation that I'm looking for its flag to be there at this place, because we are going to have our flag in when it comes January here at the UN. The UN talking about, or General Secretary General talking about, we have to work for the unity. He himself forgot that he came from China. He himself forgot that he come from Korea.
Yeah.
Which we have two Korean, although that they are one people, but they are two nations. How can we work for the unity of Sudan at the time that we are not even one people? We are not the same. Southern Sudanese are African, are Christian. Northern Sudanese claim they are Arab, and they are now even chosen to be governed by the Sharia law in the Northern Sudan. Which we're saying that, of course, we don't have a problem with anybody's religion, but it come a time for us to walk away, for we distance ourselves from them, to have our say that this is what we want for ourselves. We don't want to be Islamized, we don't want to be Arabized, and we don't want to be kept under the enslavement. And that is what we're telling the UN. And we're going to Washington, D.C. to tell American government and Obama administration that the CPA, the Comprehensive Peace Agreement that we have in the South, it was brought by the United States. It was brought by the United States government, by the United States, by the American people itself. That itself making us, we have a moral obligation and a moral obligation of our commitment that we brought that peace, and that peace have to be, to go as it is. We're saying very clear, and the United States was the witness, that in January 11, the Southern Sudanese, not all the Sudanese, the Southern Sudanese are going to choose whether they're going to go back under the Islamization and Arabization, or they're going to go free. Yes, of course, we smell freedom. 6 years is enough. Freedom is close to us. We don't want anybody to deny us. We are fired up. We have a fire in the belly. And as being said by the Secretary of the State, that the issue of Southern Sudan, of the issue of Sudan, is a time ticking bomb. We have a fire in the belly. And for us to stop that bomb that Clinton talked about not to go off, is to make sure that the South have vote in a fair and free referendum on self-determination, in which they will determine whether they're going to go back under the Islamization again, or Arabization, or in enslavement, or they're going to go free. And of course, they're going to choose freedom, because freedom is a God-given right to all people in the earth.
Amen. Now, where is the Obama administration on this? Does he support your position? Has he been helpful?
Well, that's why we're going to Washington, because that if the Secretary of State saying that the problem in Sudan is a time ticking bomb, then we have to go and find how can we dismantle that time ticking bomb before the bomb went off.
Thank you, Simon. Thank you very much. Good luck with the walk. And people can go to your website to see when it's going to hit their city and join you, right? Sudan Freedom Work.
Sudanfreedom.org.
Thank you very much.